They're the biggest, baddest, most muscle-bound team in cinema history. Forget the Dirty Dozen, keep the Avengers, we're here to talk about The Expendables. The series has grossed over $800 million at the global box office and introduced a whole new generation to the classic action stars of the 80s. So strap yourselves in, make sure you're locked and loaded, and get ready for a full assault. I'm Caleb from Val Verde Facts, and this is the top 10 things you didn't know about The Expendables. Number 1. Macadamia Nuts. Sly suffered a number of injuries and ailments during the 5-month shoot, including a cracked tooth, a ruptured ankle, shingles, and a bout of bronchitis. But none of that got the Rocky star down. In fact, he was so determined to finish the shoot that he refused to accept any medical treatment whatsoever, using his brother Frank as a stand-in for certain scenes. However, things took a turn for the worse on the final day of the shoot. The film originally contained a subplot in which Sly's character Barney Ross attempts to overcome his nut allergy by ingesting incrementally larger doses of different types of nut in order to immunise himself against their anaphylactic effects. This nearly went horribly wrong on the last day of the shoot, as the originally scripted climax to the film involved Ross attempting to eat a macadamia nut the size of a fist. Rather than rely on CGI to achieve the effect, the Italian stallion unhinged his jaw and attempted to swallow a fiberglass prop nut whole, blocking his airway. It was only a well-timed punch by co-star Jason Statham that saved the day. The strike to his abdomen dislodged the prop and sent it careening into Mickey Rourke's trailer, contributing to Rourke not appearing in the sequel. Number 2. Mickey York. Though the wrestler's Mickey Rourke was riding high at the time of The Expendables, having returned to the Hollywood limelight with Robert Rodriguez's Sin City and concurrently filming Iron Man 2 for Marvel, his star hadn't always burned so bright. Rourke endured a difficult post-fame period during the 1990s, where he abandoned acting in favour of professional boxing and was a victim to some botched cosmetic surgeries that permanently altered his classically handsome appearance. Luckily, his old friend Sylvester Stallone never forgot how they bonded in the 1980s and reached out to Mickey for a small but pivotal role in The Expendables. However, Rourke had some unusual caveats that caused the budget for the film to swell, costs that Sly covered out of his own pocket. Having fallen in love with the English city of York during a day trip to the interactive Viking museum, the Jorvik Centre, Rourke insisted that the entire production move there to shoot his scenes. Furthermore, he would only appear if the entirety of his dialogue was dubbed by Radiohead frontman Tom York and former Aston Villa and Trinidad and Tobago forward Dwight York. Though the former has no voiceover experience, the change is barely noticeable in the final cut. Number 3. Van Damme. Jean-Claude Van Damme is no stranger to big budget action. Though he declined to appear in the first Expendables, the muscles from Brussels was won over by the end result and made a more than memorable appearance as Jean Villain, the big bad of the sequel. As filming was taking place in Southeast Asia, the diminutive high kicker promised to show the whole cast his Burma. Unfortunately, his Burma got infected and was only visible while the dressing was being changed. Number 4. Chasing Statham. Now a linchpin of the series and close friend of Stallone, English hard man Jason Statham wasn't so easy to convince initially. The Lock, Stock and Snatch star had previously made a name for himself representing Great Britain as an Olympic diver and as a dancer in music videos for Escher and The Shaman. By the late 2000s, he tired of acting and wanted to return to music with an eye on founding an interpretive dance studio in his native London. Stallone insisted that the Stath had a future in high octane action and pursued him for over a year before he could be persuaded to take the role of Lee Christmas, with only one caveat: no trousers or pants. Jason had sworn off lower body clothing throughout 2009, which coincided with the shoot. Unable to change his mind, the shoot went ahead with Statham having his lower half caked in body paint and his genitals removed digitally in post-production. In one scene in which Christmas visits Buffy's Charisma Carpenter supposedly wearing white trousers, his penis and testes are briefly visible as he fights some goons on the basketball court. Number 5. Sticky Rourke. Prior to filming his scenes, Mickey Rourke visited the production in Brazil. Having recently studied the career of Daniel Day-Lewis, he stayed in character and worked as a tattoo artist, happily giving free tattoos to members of the crew and later locals of the barrio. Unfortunately, he refused to use new tattoo needles as he said this was out of character. This led to an epidemic of hepatitis B, and a World Health Organization clinic was opened in the slum shortly after filming wrapped. Number 6. Golf Lundgren. Dolph Lundgren likes golf. Number 7. Evening the Score. The score to the entire Expendables trilogy was created by the legendary film composer Brian Tyler, known these days for his work on the Megabooks Marvel and Fast and Furious franchises. However, he didn't create all the music for the first film. It was originally set to end with a 9-minute musical number penned by the legendary British composer Andrew Lloyd Webber. The song entitled Anaphylaxis of Evil was intended to tie up the nut allergy subplot mentioned earlier in this very list. It would have featured the tattoo parlour set revolving to reveal a proscenium arch and red velvet curtains, informing the audience that the entire film was a play penned by Barney Ross following the events depicted in the film. Sly would have been joined on a rotating pedestal by the American soprano Renee Fleming to perform lyrics largely describing nuts cultivated and grown in Iran, Iraq, and North Korea, and their associated fatality rates amongst those suffering from hypersensitivity to nut-based products in those respective countries. The scene was dropped once the macadamia nut finale proved unfilmable, as it was felt the number would no longer make sense. Number 8. Terry Crews has beef. Terry Crews' role of Hail Caesar was initially offered to Wesley Snipes, Forrest Whitaker, and 50 Cent, before settling on the former NFL linebacker and Idiocracy star. However, Crews would have been the fourth person to turn down a role if it wasn't for his enthusiasm for cattle herding. At the time the offer was made, Crews needed cash to put together a herd of Irish Dexter cows, as he was keen to aid the Livestock Conservancy's attempt to upgrade the breed from rare to recovering status. Furthermore, Crews was interested in Dexter cows' ability to graze on land of various quality, their high killing out percentage of over 56%, and their versatility as a dual breed, as they're able to be farmed for beef or dairy. The Dexter breed has an exceptionally rich milk that is often up to 4% butter fat, and Dexter cows can yield up to 9.5 litres a day and make exceptional mothers. They're able to nurse 2 to 3 cows at once and will often include those of other cattle. However, as a breed, they're highly prone to pulmonary hyperplasia, which is undetectable by DNA testing. This condition is typified by the incomplete formation of the lungs at the fetal stage and can lead to accumulation of fluid in the pulmonary cavity. Number 9. Gym Buddies. It probably goes without saying that The Expendables features one of the most muscle-bound casts ever assembled, with powerhouses such as Dolph Lundgren, Jean-Claude Van Damme, Terry Crews, Randy Couture, and even former Mr. Universe Arnold Schwarzenegger. With such an in-shape cast, there was always going to be a lot of competition on set. Some legendary workouts were taking place behind the scene and in between takes. However, it wasn't just the exercise that got competitive. As any fitness freak will tell you, nutrition is essential. While filming in Romania, the guys liked to chow down on the local cattle. The competition got heated over who could eat the largest steak, with Dolph Lundgren getting away with an eye-watering 150-ounce or 4,000-gram steak in just 15 minutes. Not satisfied with having out-eaten the whole team, he started to mock castmate Jet Li, who had quietly opted out of the eating competitions. Stallone himself explains what happened next in this interview with Mark Kermode from BBC Radio 5 Live.
So Dolph starts banging on Jet, you know, he's just like, "What's the matter, little guy? You want me to warm up some milk for you?" And we're all just laughing, you know, because Dolph's a funny guy, but the Jet didn't want to take that, so we sat outside the bodega in Romania. And in Romania, they got these beautiful red foxes, okay? So Jet flips his table over. I never seen him so angry. He just walks off into the woods, and we forget about it. And then we start to hear a whole lot of noise. Jet comes back with his fox, you know, and he's holding it by the legs so it can't escape. And he throws it down on the table in front of Dolph and bites down on the end of the tail. And this thing's going crazy. It starts thrashing and screaming and scratching Jet's face. But Jet just keeps eating and there's blood coming out of this thing. And Jet just won't stop. I swear to God, he ate the whole thing. Even the teeth. In 14 minutes. Crazy son of a bitch.
Number 10. Expendable footage. All movies have bloopers, blunders, fluffs and goofs. The Expendables is no exception. For example, about 35 minutes in, when Jason Statham's character leaves the truck, Sly's Barney Ross tells him not to lose his hat. Statham takes it off, but doesn't throw it away. In the next shot, it isn't in either of his hands. You thought we didn't notice Sly, but we did. In another scene later in the film, Tool, Gunner and Toll Road are discussing the greatest movie action scenes of all time. Tool uses his iPhone X to show the guys the finale to Avengers Endgame. Eagle-eyed viewers were quick to point out that Avengers Endgame wasn't released until 2019, a full 9 years after The Expendables. Even worse, the iPhone X didn't hit the market until November 2017. Thanks for checking out this video. If you liked it, be sure to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel and hit that bell. You guys are awesome and so am I. Don't forget to follow us on social media. Check out our other content, buy some merch, and spend at least 45 minutes screaming the name of your first love into a tin bucket you found in a shed.